Equilibrio 2.
Alas, I've never learned to converse with your kind.
Ah, my good friend! You were at the gates just now, no? When the goblins came? You saw them up close? A few questions, if you please. There's no overstating my interest. Glory. Now then, how would you describe that particular batch of goblins? Size, nature, distinguishing qualities? A scholar after my own heart. Spent much time among goblins? I've always preferred experience to the second-hand accounts of lesser men. But to each their own. Now, I've a few more questions, if you don't mind. And the dragon they had marching in the rear, was it of the brass or silver variety? Witness declined to comment on nature of dragon. Last question, then you'll be quite free. Did the attackers rally to the absolute when they fell upon the gates? They did, didn't they? Oh, curious indeed. I've interrogated one, a captive in this very camp. She reports they've abandoned their god, Maglubbiot, in favor of someone called the absolute. The scandal! Oh, I'd imagine him quite displeased. Since their change in allegiance, these goblins are informed by a kind of strategy anathema to their kind. I, for one, intend to get to the bottom of it. I'm just preparing to head to their camp as we speak, in fact. If you'll excuse me, I ought not to dawdle. Why, goblins, obviously. Well, someone ought to chronicle these curious events. I'd heard the master of this place, a druid called Halson, might be able to point me in the right direction. But he's been quite captured by them already. Ironic, really.
Oh, never you mind. Who needs mercy when you've a quick tongue, And an invisibility potion stashed in your back pocket.
Until we meet again.
Just a moment. This man is recording my story. I am far from home. Come on, All the druids can understand me. You can. Why can't the man with the pen? I traveled a long way. Come on, all the druids can I.
Pardon me, I must prepare to travel.
Good day, my friend.
I'll tell you. If you'd be so good as to answer a few questions pertaining to the goblins you encountered at the gates. Pardon me, I must prepare to travel.
Defendenos ab imminentibus equilibrio tuo.
Concentrating. Does this look good? Is the coin in the middle? Right here.
The bird knows. She needs to know. You do not. I... Forgive me. It is not you I fear. It is my brethren. More follow Kagha every day. They are afraid, and she offers a simple solution. Eject the refugees, and we will be safe. Perhaps not. But that does not make it right. Only Master Hulsin can stop this. pray my bird returns with news of him. If not, I fear for my people. Find Nettie in her room, through the carved door, deeper in the grove. I would prefer not to, but if Master Helsin does not return, Kagha will give the order, and my voice will not matter.
I thought you were Halsey. Where's Halsey? Promise me a mate!
She must pay the price. We will imprison the thief under guard of my serpent. When we cast out the rest.
Please! I'm sorry.
This is madness, Kagha. She's just a...
A what, Wrath? A thief? A poison? A threat? I will imprison the devil. And I will cast out every stranger. Girl, you mean parasite.
She eats our food, drinks our water, then steals our most holy idol in thanks.
Wrath, lock her up. She remains here until the rite is complete. And keep still, devil. Teela is restless.
Come, Kagha. We took back the idol. Surely...
Do it. The words of the Tree Father, spoken plain. It is as you say. Sivisif, Teela to me! Out, thief. My grace has its limits.
It hurts.
Thank you, Kagha. Master Halsin w-
Halsin isn't here. Keep his name off your tongue, lest Teela pierce it.
That woman has more venom in her heart than a snake in its fangs. But at least the child is safe. What is youth if not a time to be forgiven for one's transgressions?
Couldn't agree more. The girl wasn't innocent, but that doesn't mean she was guilty.
One who tried to steal from us.
Yet she failed. That's what matters.
I know that look. You're wondering why I was in pain before. Let's just clear the air about that now. It's just an old wound that hurts me from time to time. Nothing to be concerned about. It's nothing to do with the tadpoles, at least, in case your imagination is in danger of getting away from you. It's just something I have to live with. Quite a lot, if I'm being honest. But it always passes quickly, so I can manage. positive. You can trust me on that.
Seriously?
By letting that child escape without consequence? We might as well have lain on the ground and let them trample us.
You did well to speak up for the girl. That snake is fickle. A tragedy prevented. Well seen. Well spotted. We've let a snake replace our leader.
She is first druid in Halcyn's absence. With him caught or dared by goblins, none may gains, but more will die if her ritual is finished. I doubt those exiled by the Rite will survive long outside. Would you? I would give anything to see Halcyn return home. Sylvanas's blessing upon you, and my gratitude as well. Halcyn is an elf with the presence of a bear. He left west with the adventurers. You won't mistake the first druid for anyone else. Come, Silver. Stay close.
Please leave. Our hospitality has limits, and they were crossed long ago.
Another stranger come to vex me. What will you do? Hunt me? Grab my tail? Shout until my head hurts. Stupid or a liar, neither is needed here. Go!
Let this grove be harmed. Not again.
Leave. You are not wanted here.
Have a lot on my mind. And well.
What will the tieflings want next? Letting the hell child go was a mistake.
So many dead, sent to the Night Singer's embrace.
Moonrise must be a reference to Shah's divine sister, Saluma.
Ridiculous. We just let her run off.
She's a child.
A devil child. One who tried to steal from us.
Yet she failed. That's what matters.
Seems like a good moment to talk.
I see you. Just give me a moment. A moment.
This medicat.
There. It's up to her now. Life or death. Now, what was it you needed? You found her, but I still don't know what she can do for you. Why are you asking?
A tadpole. A mind flayer tadpole.
I'll do what I can. Come, follow me. I might be able to help. We need to be quick. This way. This one had the same problem as you. Attacked us in the woods together with some goblins.
tadpole crawled out of his head soon after. I'll do the best I can. I'm no Master Halson, mind. He'd have your tadpole out like that. Still, we have options. You don't have to be here for this.
No, I'll stay. I'd rather know exactly what you're up to.
All right. Let's see what we can do. Of course. Now, tell me what's been happening. Any symptoms? Strange events? Victims can identify each other. Not that the others know they're victims, of course. How'd you pick up the parasite? Halson was desperate to find where all this was happening. A mind flayer ship? But Master Halson was sure. Look, you've been straight with me, so I'll be straight with you. You're dangerous. If you transform here, we're all dead. But you seem like a good soul. You deserve a chance to save yourself. This is a vial of wyvern poison. Swear to me. You'll swallow it if you feel any symptoms. The thorn? Coated in a fatal toxin. It was a last resort, in case I couldn't trust you. I don't have a cure. Only a way out. I'm sorry for misleading you, but I had to be sure you weren't a threat before I told you everything. Now, do I have your word or not? Swear it. I hope it doesn't come to that, but thank you. Here. You know, I've spent my life treating folk and never once saw a mind flayer infection. Then suddenly, there's dozens of you. Maybe more. Master Halson and I were tracking them, studying them, trying to figure out what the hell was going on. Because you should all be changing. There should be a small army of mind flayers out there. But you're not. Weird powers aside, you seem perfectly normal. Mind flayers reproduce by infecting someone with their parasite. 7 gruesome days later, the victim transforms and a new mind flayer is born. The thing in your skull, though? It's different to anything in our records. It's one of their worms for sure. But this one gives you powers. Telepathic connections. And it doesn't turn you into one of them. Not yet, anyhow. Could be. But there's a lot we don't know. Infected, folks like you, have been converging on an old temple of Saluna, and I've no idea why. When Master Halson heard the adventurers were heading that way, he saw a chance to get answers, joined on the spot. Whatever he found there, he didn't make it back. I think so. I hope so. I've sent birds to find him, but they can't get close without goblins trying to shoot them down. You, though, you're one of them. Technically speaking, I mean. They won't kill someone carrying their parasite. If you can find Halson and get him out of there, we can discover what he learned. And perhaps he can save your life. How's that sound? Thank you. It would mean everything to the Grove. To me. I wish I could tell you more. But only those adventurers know what happened out there. All I can say for sure is they all went to the old temple of Saluna. And Master Halson didn't make it back. Good luck out there. And if things start to go bad, remember the vial. Remember your oath.
One step at a time, Nettie. Come on.
Wyvern poison. Never tried it, and I hope to keep it that way.
Better a quick draft than seramorphosis, nonetheless.
Better than becoming a mind flayer. Keep it, in case things start to go very wrong.
What if they tried to steal from us? Again!
We've shown them once. We take Grove lore seriously.
By letting that child escape without consequence. We might as well have lain on the ground and let them trample us.
Go on. Say it. You think I'm a monster?
Monster? Too kind. A demon, more like.
Yes, you would say so. I know you're kind. You see only villains and victims. A viper bares her fangs, defending her brood. I call her mother. You call her monster. No matter. I took back the idol of Sylvanus, and the rite is resumed. We will seal the grove, free from harm, free of intruders. The Rite of Thorns. It is the Tree Father's gift that none come to harm. When we speak the final prayer, the great vine will sprout forth. The grove will be cloaked in bramble and thorn. No one enters, no one leaves. Sanctuary. None of this can happen while outlanders infect us. Sylvanus demands that we choke them out. And mine perish if he stays. You showed great mettle at the gate. The mettle of a skilled sword for hire. I want you to provide your services to Zevlor. Offer to guide the outlanders out of the grove. I'm sure they'll reward you well. They're to be gone before final prayer. If they are not, the viper must strike. You will do more than speak. This tale ends but one way. With the Outlander rot cleansed, and the grove forever shrouded.
Watches your movements, but does not speak.
Still breathing, despite everything. Let's see.
A claw and tooth from root to thorn, the old oak's grove to wildling sworn. The mural depicts a ritual, but do not recognize the deity involved.
mural.
Darkest hour, a concord made, twixt harp and wild against the shade. Harp and wild. A riddle to some, but you understand the meaning immediately. The druids turn to the harpers for help. Unusual for such a territorial group. Rose with claw and tooth to tear the darkness from its roots. The mural depicts druid and beast fighting together. Looks like they were victorious, and yet the monsters have returned.
Their confidence, if you insist.
You ever scare me like that again, and I'll feed you to a gnoll.
Mom, I'm fine. Stop it.
Our little hellion told us what happened. Thank you. Don't know what we'd do without her.
Yeah. I mean, thank you for helping me.
It's our job to get us out of here safely, not yours.
It's my job too. The druids don't care about us. No one does.
Those dirt kissers would let us die for the sake of their bloody grove.
Then reaches for a concealed hatch. His eyes flicker to yours for an instant, then away, as if it hurts to look at you.
Well, look who's come to visit. My kids say you've been busy since you got here. I heard you helped Melly with that locket. I owe you for that. Mercon says you got him out of a tight spot with some harpies. Gotta say, I'm impressed. You saved Arabella from the Druids. Don't know what those bastards would have done. And thanks for going easy on Sylphie. Not many marks would have done the same. And we're happy to be helped. Now, what can I do for you? We're saving up for a better hideout when we get to Baldur's Gate. Why? You planning on telling me stealing is wrong? Won't turn down free money. I've got operating costs you wouldn't believe. Come see me in the city sometime, huh? I'll repay this and then some. See you around, maybe. Yes, coming.
Oh. Hello again. Mole's in charge here, not me.
I need new pockets to pick.
We're going to own that town.
You don't look so tough. Mole fought off a hobgoblin all by herself.
I should thank you properly for the harpies. So I wrote you a story. It's about you. I hope you like it.
Sorry about the nest. You guys find anything good today?
No. Everyone's got junk. Worse than junk.
Don't worry, kid. In Baldur's Gate, purses practically grow on trees. Be patient. We'll get there.
You're blocking my light.
Oh, I remember you. You're the one who helped me get away. You want something? Were you just here to stare at my forehead? Look, if I had it, would I tell you? This entire conversation is a waste of our time, don't you think? Now find yourself a maze and get lost. I'm busy.
Give Mole a 10-day and she'll...
I had a feeling you'd be back. Anything else? You've been a friend to us. Come back anytime. Never see us coming.
Waiting's getting.
Hells take me. What I wouldn't do for better tools.
Goblins, gnolls.
Easy, Moni.
Hope the goblins aren't smart enough to poison their blades.
I heard what happened. Thank you for protecting the child. If the druids are this far gone, then it's not just goblins we have to fear.
So we can risk violence here, or face it for certain on the road. Quite the choice, isn't it?
You saw what they were willing to do to a child just for trying.
It's Kagha's influence. Without her twisting things, I believe the druids might see sense.
A low thought, but I'd be lying if I said I hadn't considered it. But the druids would slaughter us. We'd have to get close to Kagha, within striking distance. I can't manage that, but they've already let you pass once. It doesn't sit well with me either, but to get these people to safety, there's nothing I won't do. You'd be well rewarded for the risk. But if that won't sway you, there's nothing more to discuss.
Just Zevlor, Tilly. We're civilians now, remember?
With respect, sir.
They can.
I ain't leaving zone for a good while after this.
Dropping it. We're exposed now.
Never ends.
defending others. You will be missed.
Aridin's back with his tail between his legs. I'm glad for your help, but I'd hoped you were Halsin. By all rights, he was a good man. I saw enough of him to agree. And I'm tired of good people dying. That's for sure.
In without an invitation. I wouldn't call that friendly. See, you're in my territory, and I want you gone. How about this? You can stay if you keep those ugly feet on the ground.
I'll even sweeten the pot. Found some weird smelling stuff on the ground. You can keep it, but...
These trees are mine. Follow the rules and I won't have to intervene. Got it?
For discussion.
Need anything else? Of course, but please, remember, you're not the only one in need. Sylvanas be with you. Need anything else? Of course. But please, remember, you're not the only one in need. Sylvanas be with you.